my name is Elizabeth Ercito. I'm the Director of Community at Leap Motion, and we're here at GDC 2015.
So explain your technology as it relates to virtual reality.
So Leap Motion is where 3D input meets 3D output. And we like to take your hands that you would use every day in the real world to move objects, and just as you would every day, replicate that in virtual reality. So we have a small USB controller that uses two infrared cameras and three LED lights, and that actually then takes your 3D hand and replicates that.
What does that mean for video games?
So it means you can have everyday natural movement in video games now. So if I wanted to move a chess piece, I'd be able to do that in virtual reality. If I wanted to open a door or hold a lantern, you're able to now naturally interact without other technology like gloves or things obscuring your interaction. It makes it a much more immersive experience.
How easy is it for game developers to implement this technology?
It's very easy. They can get set up in minutes. So we have Unity assets that are available in the Unity Store, Unreal Direct Engine integration as well, and many other languages that are supported natively. And the SDK is free and open to any developer that has the Leap Motion controller.
And would this type of technology work on things like the new PlayStation Morpheus or the HTC Vive, pretty much any VR device?
We're working on that. So we have to make sure that languages actually work and are compatible, but we have a lot coming. So right now we have Oculus integration and we have OS VR. Android is coming out next, and it'll hopefully help us support many more HMDs.
How do you see this working with traditional video game controllers for different types of games?
We think it's a really interesting way to augment your experience and lets you interact in a way that you haven't before. So if you wanted to solve a really intricate puzzle, or really, like, you know, instead of sitting there with a mouse and keyboard, maybe explore or mold clay or create or paint in 3D, you'd be able to do that.
So it'd be very easy to go on the fly between playing with a controller and then using your hands for something?
Yeah, I think it's meant to augment your current experience and setup. It wouldn't be something that you could literally just to go from your mouse and move your hand and go back to your mouse and keyboard setup if you needed to. Again, it's meant to really augment your experience and be a part of your setup and your traditional gaming setup.
Do you see similarities between the types of experiences we've seen on Kinect and those types of controllers?
Well, Kinect is full body, and we're really focused on precise motion tracking and control, so it's generally a much more tighter personal experience than it is a whole room or full body experience so far. But
you guys,
we're gonna get there.
You guys have the ability to do a whole body down the road?
I can't say something about down the road that far. That's pretty far out, but we definitely can track all the way to your elbow right now, and there'll be many more things on the horizon.